I'm on the 14 carats, I'm 14 carats, doing it up like my ass. Hey guys, welcome back. So I really hope I'm in focus. I've been trying to get this thing to focus for forever, but because the Christmas lights are on in the background, it's kind of getting confused, I guess you could say. So yeah, so hopefully I'm in focus and won't have to record this over again. But I figured I would do another story time for you guys because I know how much you like them. And this one I was actually thinking about a few days ago because my sister was like asking me if I had ever had like a near-death experience. And this is probably the closest I could say that has ever happened to me because yes, I've been in like car accidents and things like that, but it's never been to the point where I was literally like scared for my life. But I figured I'd just jump right into this video and tell you about it. It's super quick, so don't expect to be here forever, but it is pretty interesting. So a couple years ago, before I was married or anything like that, I met this guy through mutual friends on Facebook, and we would kind of like just talk back and forth, especially when I was in college. We would just talk a lot, and just like on a friend level and things like that. It was never really like anything more than that. But when I came back from college one summer, I do remember that I was hanging out with him a lot. I would go to like, we would go to the mall, not the mall, we would go to the movies and we would go out to eat and things like that. And just hanging out as friends. It was never anything more than that. We had never kissed, anything like that. So it was just strictly like a chill, hanging out, talking. Also, let me mention, I am not like a party girl. I have probably went to, I could probably count how many times I've been to the club on one hand. That's just like me. I don't know. I'd rather sit at home and watch movies. That's just my personality. So I'm not really too much of a club girl, but I do like going out for like my birthday, big events, things like that. Before I had kids, I've just never been that way. So one time he had called me up and he had told me that he was going to a house party. And I at first was like a little like not into it, but he had kind of convinced me to go. So I was like, okay, you know, I'm not doing anything else tonight. I'll just go to this house party with you. So he picked me up and we went to the house party, and it was like this really big house. And if you know Jersey, it's kind of, I believe it was in, not West Orange, it might have been East Orange. And that's kind of like, I wish I could show, if I have a house to show you a resemblance of, I'll put it in there. But it's like just this really big, maybe multi-family house. So yeah, I just remember going there, parking literally in the front of the house, and you could hear music like blaring and everything. So we went to the backyard and there was tons of people there. It was literally packed. I remember there was a patio actually on the back as well. So there was a lot of people, I remember, in a circle around this big radio they had, and they were dancing, like doing some type of dance off. And then there was like drinks up at the patio. So when we first got there, he was like, do you want a drink? You know, I'll make you a drink. So I was like, okay. So we went up to the patio area, and we went actually inside, and directly inside was the kitchen, and they had all types of drinks on the table as well. And so he went over to the drinks area, and I forgot what he had made me. I wasn't even too much of a drinker then, so I don't even think I drank it. I think I was just like holding it. So we were just in the kitchen talking for a minute, and then he was like, oh, let's go back out to the party and, you know, see what's going on. So I was like, okay. So we walked back out and we walked down the patio stairs, and the patio is like literally in the back of the house, and I'm standing on the side of the patio, which is on the driveway, and the driveway heads to the front. So I'm standing there on the side of the patio and just watching everyone else because I don't know anyone. So my friend also, I should mention, he is Nigerian. So there was a lot of Nigerians there, but I did also see like a Caucasian couple there as well. So I was just like, oh, you know, it's that diverse crowd. You know, you got me, the Nigerians, the Caucasians. And I was like, this is chill, you know? So I'm just watching everyone. And mind you, I'm not even a dancer anyway. I'm not going to be up there dancing with everyone. But all of a sudden, out of nowhere, there was like, I can't even hardly explain it because the way it happened, I was just like, what's going on? But everybody started jumping onto the patio and like started fighting. I don't know who they were fighting. It was like they were fighting this, I think it was like 2-3 guys on the floor, and there was a lot of other people on the floor on top of them. And it was like out of nowhere because everyone was getting along, laughing and everything. So out of nowhere, all you see is like this fight going on the patio, and everybody that was on the grass area starts running onto the patio and starts like, well, at least not everybody, all the guys were doing that except like the guy I came with, and he's just looking shocked like, what's going on too? So they're all like on top of each other fighting and things like that.
And I'm just like, this is weird. And mind you, I'm right next to the patio, so I start backing up because I'm like, I don't want to be around this. And I'm backing up kind of like towards the driveway because I'm not like, I don't like seeing fights. I'm not into that drama. I'm a scaredy cat. So I'm walking towards the driveway because I know the driveway is towards the front. And I'm kind of like, I can still see the fight going on, but I'm still at the driveway. And then all of a sudden, and I know this sounds weird, but I kid you not, this is exactly what happened. All of a sudden, I see the Caucasian people run past me. And I'm like, wait a minute, if they're running, I'm gonna run with them because obviously they're running for a reason. And right before I went to run, because I saw them pass, and I looked over, and right before I went to run, I saw like a glitter, I don't know, like how you could say it, like I saw like, it looked like a gun came out, like I saw it, and I was like, oh, I was so scared. So I literally started running towards the front, and then my friend was right behind me as well, and all of a sudden we heard like gunshots, and we looked at each other, and he was like, was that a gun? And I'm like, I don't know, get in the car, unlock the door, and, like I'm screaming, and literally I looked back, and everybody from the party that was on the patio and everybody else was running from the patio to the driveway to the front. So you see this huge crowd of everyone just running out. So he unlocked the door, we got into the car, and we rode off. And I just remember like being so scared, and he was still like, was that a gunshot? Like he kept repeating himself, and I'm like, what the hell was that? Like we were so like chickened out. I remember afterwards we just ended up going home because it was just like it just shook us up so much. But yeah, that was like the only near death experience I have, and probably, and that was actually the very last house party I've ever went to. I don't think you'll be seeing me in any more house parties. And in fact, I don't even remember if anyone got shot. I remember checking the news, but I don't remember seeing if anyone got shot. But that was definitely one of the craziest experiences ever. And I just remember seeing the gun coming out, and I just remember like knowing it was time for me to go. So yeah, that was just too crazy. But that was just a really quick story time video for you guys. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.